Hi, my name is Marion Kelmer, and this is the continuation of our series about the importance of doing your own on-farm research. I've been doing it for 30-some years. Today's topic is actually on the population and row spacings in growing corn. So every spring when I get into the cab and I'm sitting there at the monitor getting ready to set it, the first thing that comes to my mind is what's the seed cost? And you think about it, it's going to run about $4 per thousand plants. So therefore, with a little bit of economics now with today's grain prices, I'm figuring I've got to have a bushel and a half response for every 1,000 kernels in order to give me some profit margin to work with. I can also tell you of all the years I've done research, there certainly is a yield advantage to increasing populations. But at my farm, I'm always looking for the maximum economic yield, not necessarily the maximum physical yield. And at my farm, believe it or not, over the last 10 years, that the most economical is that when I have 28,000 on the screen when I'm planting. So I plant all my corn at 28. As far as row spacings are concerned, I've been looking at that for about 20 years, comparing 30s versus 15s. The first thing I'll say about corn is that it's a grass. And we don't plant our yards in rows. We don't plant our hay fields in rows, our cow pastures, or oats field, or wheat. Everything is solid seeded, and therefore I think the corn should be solid seeded as well. And 15 inches by 15 inches is not a bad place to be. Therefore, with solid seeded, that's going to give me maximum weed control. It's going to give me maximum yield, and it's going to give me maximum erosion control, and ultimately it's going to maximize my profitability as well. So stay tuned at the end of this video, and we'll show you our data that we've collected over many years, replications, and many different growing seasons. So with that, I want to say thanks for watching the video. We do want you to stay tuned. There will be more of these coming along here this spring. And with that, have a safe and profitable planting season.